Pastor Alan Haskins of Word Alive Ministries. I am, and Brother Joseph here is on my right. Thank God for when we met in 2014, October 2014. I was going into the food town, and I saw him sitting on the bench, laying on the bench, and I don't know, I'm the type of guy, I like to help anybody and everyone, and I just stopped and said, "Brother, are you all right? Is everything fine?" And he said, "Yes, sir." So I just reached in my $20 bill and went on in the store. Praise God. And here we are now, what, 2 years later, going full circle. And I invited him to church. He came to the church, and God has turned his life around.
Life takes you to some changes. And when you keep God in your equation, you know, he'll take you to places that you never thought you'd go. And he would, you know, he'd hold you up in the midst of the storm and teach you courage. You have to have courage. And I've lived homeless quite a bit of my life. And just these past 2 or 3 years, I tell you, meeting Pastor Adam was the transition of my rededicating my life back to Christ. A beautiful man. Spoke to him, found no judgment in his spirit. So I knew that God had placed him in my life. And then after that, you know, just a change of circles, And I heard God say, "Well, you know where to go." So one day I decided I would go. And I went to him 2 or 3 times and hadn't really gotten into the church yet. But this past 3 or 4 or 5 months, I said, "You know what? I've got to go to church. I've got to get back into where God brought me from and to where I was created to be in the church." I found so much love in Word Alive Ministry from not only the pastor and my first lady, just some beautiful people all the way around. And I found that the congregation had a heart much like the pastor, because they embraced me with the love that I really needed. So God knew where I needed to be. And I'll never forget the first day we met. I'll never forget that day as long as I live. Little did I know until a few months back that was God's transitioning me to a shepherd after his own heart. Somebody that would nourish me and help me understand how important it is to live a holy and righteous life. And began to nourish me back. And I started going. I kept going. And a lot of times I was in the same clothes. You know, I was kind of dirty sometimes, but never got turned away. Never felt any judgmental spirits in my going to the church. And I just kept going. I kept going. And one night, it's been about maybe 4 months ago, I was sleeping in the park, Ogundishan Park. And it was cold on Friday night. And I think I had left the church that Wednesday night. I'd been in Bible study. And that Friday night, or Thursday, Friday, kind of running around a little bit like I always do. And that Friday night, he was kind of sleeping. It was a little cold. But later on that night, in the morning, 1:30, 2 o'clock in the morning, I got real cold and sleep. And I laid down, covered myself up, and went to sleep. And I guess about 4:30 or 5 o'clock that morning, that wind picked that cover up off me and blew it off me. And I was still asleep. And I guess about 3 or 4 minutes later, strong wind, it woke me up. And I mean, it was cold. Normally I was stood in it. That morning, it was just too cold. So I got up, put my blankets around me, and I went to St. John Baptist Church. And I sit on the steps, kind of back of the window style there, so the wind wouldn't hit me. And I felt asleep. It's about maybe an hour, 45 minutes to an hour. And I woke up, sun started coming out. I was 6:30, 7 o'clock, I guess. Saw the sun start coming out. Wind had settled down. So I went on back to the park, made my blanket, and I slept all that Saturday in the park. And got up that Saturday night, and I slept all day to about 7:30, 8 o'clock at night. And you know, they call it the set when you're in the streets, they call it the set. So I got up and I walked back down to the set. And I don't know if you know Jennifer Lewis. She said, man, and they call me Man Clay, it's my nickname. She said, Man Clay, I thought about you all night last night in that cold. She said, but we've got a room at the house that you can come and stay in. And little did I know, she left, she got a bicycle. And you know, I know she left and went home, but she talked to her husband. And he said, yeah. You know, and, he didn't really know who she was talking about, but he's a pretty good guy himself. So she came back, she said, bring all your stuff. And so I brought all the little bedroll and backpack and went to her house. And when I got there, they opened the door. She opened the bedroom door. She called his name. She said, Roland. He said, this is what I'm talking about. And he turned up and looked at me. He said, yes. He said, man, I can stay in my house anytime. I went back there in the room, and I mean, just, the peace. You know, you go to some people's house, you can't sense the peace. But it was so much peace in that house. And it was a Saturday night. So I laid down, went to sleep. I mean, beautiful sleep. Woke up that Sunday morning and came to church. Well, I had seen my fiance a week or so later, before that, but we hadn't talked in a while. And you know, we've been together, my wife, my future wife and I, we've been together a little bit over 4 years, better. So I hadn't talked to her. So Jenny kept, you want to call, baby? I said, nah, I don't want to talk to baby. Well, you want me to call? I said, nah, just leave baby where she at. So she said, okay. So I went on and went to bed that Sunday night. And we had a beautiful service that morning in church. We had a beautiful service that morning. So I went on back to the house. I laid down and I went to sleep. So that Monday, some type of way, I don't know. I'm just going to say it was the Lord. Her and Jenny was talking on the telephone. And she said, well, put him on the phone. So she put me on the phone and we talked for a few minutes. She said, well, baby, I'll be down there sometime this on a Monday. She said, late Monday evening. She said, I'll be down there sometime this tonight. I said, okay. You got any money? I didn't have any money, but I told her I did. I said, yeah, baby, I got a few dollars. So she came on down, and her and my oldest daughter was in the car. So I jumped in the back seat. She said, you have any money? I said, no, baby, I don't have any money. She said, well, yeah, I said, you want me to get out? Mm-hmm. And she kind of pushed the accelerator a little bit harder. She said, well, you're going to ask the Erica if you can come with her. And her oldest daughter said, I don't care. And that's where the transition began. I thank God for this girl, because I remember when we first met, I was kind of headstrong, kind of off in the drugs a little bit and stuff like that. She said, you know, Joe, she said, I love you. She said, I'm concerned about your soul. And I guess a year or so later, I fell in love with the girl. And I was still kind of acting a little crazy, you know, talking crazy. You know how you do when you're in the world. But she nourished me all the way through. And I'll tell anybody, anytime, she's a friend. And she's a friend indeed. When I was at my lowest in life, she was there for me. And she never turned around. She'd leave me a few days, but she'd always come back. And I thank God for the day. I remember when we first got back together, I said, baby, I said, if you want to see the heavens open up in our life, say, marry me, be my wife. And for the first time in 4.5, almost 5 years, she said, I'll marry you. I said, we're going to go to my church now. And for for the first time since we've been back with the four other churches. She said, okay. And that's how we ended up the Word Alive Ministry. I guess the beautifulest place, the beautifulest church I've been in a long time. And I've been in quite a few of them. And I just say that I pray that God will give our pastors and first ladies a heart of God, like the Word of Life ministry leaders. And they're beautiful people. I'll tell the world they're beautiful people, and that'll be a testimony for the rest of my life, because I've surrendered my life to Jesus, and I'll never go back. And I love my pastor and First Lady Katrina Haskins. I love her with all my heart. I brought my wife, I brought my fiance to church, and they just adapted to her the same way. And I remember First Lady Katrina saying, okay, girl, I love this, we love this guy. And that's how it all started. And that's how it's all going to end. That I'll tell anybody, there's power in the name of Jesus to break every chain that have you bound in life. And I'll tell that story the same way I told it today, 20 years from now.
I just believe this, you know, love is the ultimate. We should have learned to walk in the compassion of Christ and have no respect of person in life. Have the passion of Christ. One thing we teach at Word Alive, man, God is a God of restoration. That's our ministry, by restoring lives through the Word of God and reaching out to the less fortunate, and love beyond them that Christ loved on the multitude. So we teach love. We teach compassion, we teach trust and have faith in God that all things are possible.
Yes.
But you have to listen, and we bring Joe and I talk about, we have to listen to the voice of God.
Yes.
It's the voice of God. It's not our voice, it's the voice of God. I remember Brother Joseph when I was in Washington, D.C. since the pandemic. I remember stopped there. And I just had bought me a pack of socks from the sub down to the went to the railroad station on the ground, bought a brand new pack of 10 pack of socks. And on my way back to the hotel where we was living, we was come through the park, and God said, give that man your socks. I said, wait a minute, Lord, I just bought these socks. He said, no, give that man your socks. So in order to reach and be like Christ, you have to hear the voice of Christ.
Yes.
And do what he asks you to do.
No
give,
doubt about
give
it.
Up, give up yourself and give up what he asks you to do. Yeah. We feed people, we clothe people, just like the Bible says. So I believe we trust the Bible and trust what he says. You can help people reach their destiny and reach Christ and let Christ fulfill his purpose in their life.
Yes.
Because if you read your Bible, the Bible says God got no respect to person.
Yes.
So he loves us all and cares for us all, and our job is to help him reach and love everyone.
For the first time in 4.5, almost 5 years, she said, I'll marry you.